Although many of these contaminants derive as a consequence from using things that make the world a much better place, some contaminants are arguably unnecessary.
A lot of us buy antimicrobial products. Why? Because that's the first stuff we grab when we reach into the shelves of supermarkets. And so there's lots of antimicrobial products that are being pushed by marketing to the consumers. Principals of schools and parents get encouraged to buy antimicrobial school supplies. Markers, highlighters are containing antimicrobials, triclosan, and so forth.
We have found some triclosan, which is a disinfectant product that's used in antibacterial soaps and other materials.
Do we need antimicrobial products that are loaded with persistent chemicals? Sometimes yes. If you undergo an operation in a clinic, you know, I think it's a great idea to have these types of products. But for the average consumer, oftentimes there's actually zero benefit of adding this type of persistent chemistry to a regular soap. There have been studies, including those by the Food and Drug Administration, an expert panel, that decided that there is no measurable benefit of using these compounds in the household. If we use it and wash our hands, the contact time between the chemical and the bacteria on our hands is too short for the chemical to be effective. So the chemical is being washed into the sewer. The sewer takes it to the wastewater treatment plant. The wastewater treatment plant removes as much as it can, but it can't deal with these chemicals very effectively. So about half or three quarters of the mass of these chemicals coming to the plants ends up in the sewage sludge. The sewage sludge then is applied on land, and it doesn't degrade very quickly either there. It is actually taken up sometimes by plants and can make it back into the food supply. We actually breed antimicrobial resistance to drugs that are in clinical use. And so we know that as we use more and more antibiotics and antimicrobials, these chemicals actually become less and less effective, and it takes many, many lives every year. So this is a huge public health problem, and it's really an educational issue. People don't know about it. They have no sense that the chemicals that they get in their personal care products potentially have harmful effects on the environment, and they are left with the belief that they actually help. I think if we would put into the marketing message that you can detect triclosan in 99% of breast milk samples from US women, if that message would get out, people wouldn't buy all these products.